This video demonstrates how to use the CboxQC for outline measurements and measurements with the piercing and filling device PFD. Turn on the instrument. Check the instrument status. Confirm that the correct method, sample ID, and units are set. Prepare and connect the filter, adapter, and hoses. Ensure all connections are tight. Cut the hoses straight and short as possible. Sanitize and connect the adapter or inlet hose securely to the sampling point. Put the outlet hose in the waste container. Start rinsing. Open the tank sampling valve and valve at the back of the instrument. Rinse until the temperature and O₂ readings stabilize and no bubbles remain in the measuring chamber. If the tank or line pressure is low, around 1 bar, position the instrument upright and as low as possible to ensure bubble-free filling. Close the ball valve and start the measurement. After the measurement is finished, close the tank sampling valve and disconnect the instrument. When finished with measurements, rinse the instrument. Open the ball valve. Connect a chlorine-free process or purified water supply. Open the water supply and rinse for at least 30 seconds. If the flow is blocked, clean the filter and perform a backflush. Swap the sample inlet and outlet hoses and repeat the rinsing steps. The instrument can also be rinsed with a syringe using at least 200 milliliters of purified water after the rinsing starts. You can also perform a backflush with a syringe if needed. To install the PFD, first connect the black hoses for a gas supply. And the transparent hoses with a filter for sample transfer. Ensure connections are tight. Ensure an appropriate pressure supply. Use nitrogen gas minimum class 5 for oxygen measurements. Ensure the ball valve is closed. Check the instrument status and confirm that the correct method, sample ID, and units are set. Set the rinsing time of minimum 30 seconds to fill the measuring chamber and avoid sample carryover. Always measure samples at a consistent, stable temperature. For O₂ measurement, shake 3 minutes using a lab shaker. For CO₂, shake sample back and forth 15 times. Place the glass bottle in the center of the PFD, lower the piercing head until the marking disappears, and lock it. For a new measurement, just lift the handle a little and place the bottle inside. Turn the can upside down, place it in the PFD, and lower the piercing head. For cans with deep bottoms, use the PFD spacer included with the device. For PET bottles, an adapter is needed, because they need to hang during measurement. When the sample is positioning right, lower the safety shield and activate the pressure. Insert the sample tube to the bottom, then slightly lift it when using the PFD+. Start the measurement. If the filling pressure is too low or bubbles appear in the measuring chamber during measurement, check the gas supply pressure and verify all connections. If the issue persists, clean the external filter. If the packaging is stuck, turn it counterclockwise and pull down. After measurements, rinse the instrument with deionized water. The results are shown on screen and stored in the instrument's memory. Data can be exported to a PC using a USB or the AP Connect adapter. Clean the instrument daily using laboratory cleaner. First, insert a bottle with purified water and rinse with approximately 300 milliliters. Repeat the rinsing procedure with cleaning agent and two bottles of purified water. Once a week, perform special chlorine-based cleaning using the cleaning function. Insert the bottle with the cleaning agent into the PFD Plus and activate it. Start the cleaning procedure and follow the guided wizard. Perform a CO₂ system check before you start your working day. The check verifies the zero point of CO₂ and measures the chamber tightness. If you are using a PFD, fill purified water at room temperature, free of CO₂ and chlorine, in a clean 500 ml PET bottle. If you are using the instrument outline, connect the instrument to a CO₂-free, chlorine-free process water line. Precondition the instrument first with one measurement. Then open the CO₂ system check and follow the guided wizard. You can confirm the successful check results. If the value is out of tolerance, clean the instrument and repeat the CO₂ system check. If the issue persists, you need to perform a CO₂ pressure offset adjustment. Ensure you use CO₂-free water, otherwise the adjustment will be incorrect. Perform an O₂ system check once a week with pure nitrogen. The check verifies the zero point of the O₂ measurement. First, clean the instrument using a cleaning agent. Connect the sample inlet to a gas or oil-free compressed air supply. Dry by rinsing for at least 4 minutes at approximately 3 bar relative pressure. Keep the instrument in the lab overnight and run the check the next morning before measurements. Connect the nitrogen supply and ensure both the gas and instrument are at the same stable temperature. Close the ball valve and place the waste hose into a water-filled vessel to check for gas flow through the instrument. Apply nitrogen overpressure and start rinsing until the O₂ reaches a stable minimum. Start the O₂ system check and follow the instructions on the screen. CboxQC. Your CO₂ and O₂ meter.